Everyone connects their coils different ways. I've seen generally that once a coil is varnished, you just got a tail of wire sticking out. The problem with that is if it's just varnished, there's no support on the end, that over a period of time that wire can unravel itself and change the parameters of the coil. I know it probably won't change by much, but it's enough. The method I like to use for anchoring is to drill a couple of small holes in the coil former and feed the wire in and back out again, and that gives you an anchored tail. The problem with that is that again, you know, the wire moves about when you erect and take apart your coil, that the wire eventually breaks off. Again, you've got a problem. So one of the things that I always used to do was put aluminium foil on the end, and when you do aluminium foil, you always leave a gap on the side, otherwise you've got a shorter turn. But the idea was that you strip the end of the enamel and you put it under a piece of foil tape, and that gives you a contact. Well, it doesn't. Here's a typical example. I'll just bring the meter in. This is a piece of foil tape on a piece of Perspex. Doesn't really matter what material it's on. And the meter I put around to continuity. If I go onto the wire, which is stripped at the end, and onto the foil, there's no continuity whatsoever. Now, I don't know if it'll make a better contact if I rub it down a bit more, and it doesn't. So there's no actual continuity between the foil and the wire. What you will get is, first of all, you get capacitance in there, and you might get some arcing, and that might eventually make some sort of contact. Problem with aluminium foil, it's hard to solder to, but yeah, you can solder to aluminium, but it takes a special solder, and people are not going to do that for their coils, unless they're into it in a big way. So what I've been doing, this is very recent, is using copper foil. Now, as you can see there, it's soldered onto the foil. That's going to make a good connection, and I've left a gap in the side there, and then the other end again there's a gap, but because I've got a wider piece on the top end, I've just put a piece of foil coming up from the bottom and then joined it in. I'm just going to do that on one of the other coils. So this is another way that I used to do these. It was partly for anchoring the coil to the base so that the coil didn't get knocked over, but yeah, I always put in an end cap into the coil, and that helped with turning the coil for winding, and then I just leave the cap in there, and it brings out contact from the center. Either a bolt I used to have sticking out that went through, then I put a nut underneath on the RF earth, or on this one I put a wire from the inside to the outside and then soldered onto the wire for the winding. The other end, as you can see, that's the foil method, and I'm sure that there's not really a very good contact between there. It did work, but I'm not sure whether it lost a bit of meaning. I'll do the top end. First of all, I'm going to clean off the tape that's on there and make a fresh start. So that's the old aluminium foil tape removed. Now this is the copper tape, and if you want to get some, this is advertised as snail repellent. You'll see copper tape that's advertised in the craft departments of Amazon and that. Whether it's real copper or whether it's just copper effect tape, not sure, but if you go for the one that says snail repellent, then that's going to be copper. because for some reason snails and slugs don't like the copper. Now I've set a compass to a bit less than the width of the tape, and I'll just generally put a mark around the top as a guideline. Makes it look a bit neater when you do the job, of course. I know people struggle with getting a start on the copper or on the aluminium foil. The way I find is if you get a sharp craft knife, just run it across the copper very lightly and pull, it will reveal the white backing. And if you put your knife on the white backing and go under the copper, you can start to peel the tape away from the backing very easily. I'm going to line up the tape with the line. What I'm trying to do is just cover the line so it's not so obvious. Although being a pencil it could be rubbed off fairly easily. I just finished doing the wrapping of the copper. As I mentioned earlier, I've left a gap, and you'll notice that the copper is wrinkled, but you rub that down enough and that gets rid of the wrinkles. If it goes off the line slightly, it will stretch a little bit. Don't pull it too much because you can easily tear this stuff. I don't know if it comes in various thicknesses, it's a bit stronger, but this is what I've got, so just rub it down. And then the reason why I've marked it less than the width of the tape was so that the top can fold over. And what that does is gives you a top surface where your top load can make contact to. And if you've got a plate on the bottom of your base, then that copper will also make contact with that. What I'm doing on the last couple of coils, I've got some old battery terminals. These were from an old charger and they're spring connections, and I'm making taking these off of the board, and they actually make contact with the copper itself. And you might say, well, these contacts are a bit small, but remember that you know, you've got, in my case, 100 milliamps of wire, like 1,000 watts of energy on my two transformers. And if you translate 1,000 watts from 240 to whatever, you know, however many 1,000 volts you're going to be putting out your coil, it comes down into microamps. So there's not a lot of current going through the secondary on, you know, generally the tabletop or home coils. Now what I like to do is, this is ideally, I'd like to have the wire at the back, but I'm not too worried. This is only for home use. And when you strip your enamel, I used to work in a transformer factory, and one of my jobs was to solder up transformers. And the way we used to do it there was to use the knife. But this is the top, so this is going to have a piece going up, and the idea is that you scrape gently. You don't want to, force it in and cut your wire. You're just taking off the varnish. And then somewhere around here I've got a piece of emery cloth. I'm sure it doesn't need it. We didn't used to use emery cloth in the battery. So this is going to have the extra piece coming up. If you've got a wider piece on the top, then this looks much better than having your wire coming up, in my opinion. And all you do is to put your copper tape coming up the side, and then I like to put this around the back, but it doesn't look too bad on the front. And then just part way up, just gently put a cut mark, and it will tear fairly easily along that line. Now obviously that's going to be adhesive on the back of there, which is going to be a bit of an insulator, so just to make sure that we're getting a good contact, what I'll do is just flow a bit of solder across that joint. And this stuff does solder very easily without much heat, so you're not going to melt your plastic. This is just a quick joint, obviously you'll do a cleaner job than that if I'm rushing through this. Just tidy up that end so it looks a bit nicer. Just cut through. And then just lay your copper wire across the bottom of the strip. Ideally you want something to hold that down when you solder it. All I'm going to do is to essentially tin both parts and then just push it down and finally fix it. So that's both parts tin, and then just make it flat. Enamel wire didn't quite get tinned, so I didn't use emery cloth on that. There you go. And that wire is now making contact. So that's the way that I'm doing my coils these days. This one I'm changing up to do it this way. I've done it on Deep Purple, that's been updated, as you can see. Same method on that, the solder joint at the top and then the copper wire in the bottom, and then the top is just the bottom of the coil is just straight onto the copper wire again, leaving the gap to stop the shorted turn. And if you don't want to use the spring method and you want to solder onto the copper for your tail wire, I'll just use this demonstration piece. If that's the copper that's on the bottom of the coil, and you want to put a tail wire on to connect to your RF earth, whether it be a bit more enamel copper wire or a piece of flexible wire, whichever, so now you've attached your tail wire to the bottom of the coil, which is one way of doing things. You could of course drill a hole through and put a nut and bolt through, and that'll be your ring terminal. But what you might want to worry about is, you know, if you pull your wire, you're going to have a hole in your tape. Well, that's easy enough to solve, because all you need to do Let's get another piece of copper pipe, tape, put it over the hole, and just make sure that yeah, if you could connect in the same place again, you can just run a piece of solder along at least one of the edges to remake your contact, and then you can put your wire back on as you require. So there's a few sort of tips there. So I'd certainly recommend getting copper tape for the tops and bottoms of your coils. Not that expensive for what it is. Remember, it is copper, and it does the job really nicely.